We think we're very well positioned because, one, very large scalable resource, very low cost, construction ready, so looking to go into construction later this year. Very importantly, we produce an NdPr oxide. What that means is we process 95% towards a metal, which allows us to bypass the China supply chain.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Arafura Rare Earths CEO Darryl Cuzzubbo joins me now. Darryl, very good to speak with you. For viewers not familiar with the company, tell us more about Arafura Rare Earths.
Sure. Thanks for the invitation, Stephen. Arafura has a construction-ready rare earths project, producing neodymium and praseodymium, which are the two rare earth elements that you need in electric vehicles and wind turbines. We're construction-ready. We're in the final step of securing funding, at which point we will move into construction. We have two binding agreements with Hyundai and Kia, as well as Siemens Gamesa.
I mean, tell us more about the demand you're seeing for these rare earths going forward, and how are you going to help fill that gap?
Yes. So these rare earths have traditionally been used in everyday electronics, iPhones, iPads, loudspeakers, but the demand is expected to double over the next decade, driven by electric vehicles and wind turbines. And then beyond that will be driven even more so by robotics. So anything that requires strong permanent magnets, such as electric vehicles, robots, etc., needs these two rare earth elements.
And your Nolans project is quite sizable. In fact, you estimate that it could actually meet about 4% of rare earths demand or supply going forward.
Yeah, that's right, Stephen. So demand, as I mentioned, will double. But if you look at the supply projects, the pipeline supply projects, it's pretty bare. So you've got this rapid demand, but the sort of projects that can come on stream in the next 5 to 10 years is quite limited. Today, China controls nearly 90% of supply. So we think we're very well positioned because, one, very large scalable resource, very low cost, construction ready, so looking to go into construction later this year. And very importantly, we produce an NdPr oxide. So what that means is we process 95% towards a metal, which allows us to bypass the China supply chain. And that's what our off-takers, the EV manufacturers, the wind turbines want to see.
And you're also looking at a 38-year life of mine, at least, Darryl.
Yeah, that's right. So the ore body is very large. It is open at depth at 400 meters, and the 38 years that you talk about is only the first 200 meters. So this is a multi-decade mine.
You're out with your quarterly activities report towards the end of January, and quite a few highlights over that quarter, Darryl. And one which stands out is a $200 million Australian dollar commitment from the National Reconstruction Fund Corporation. So really putting confidence in that project.
Yeah, that's right. So if you look at our funding strategy, it has been first to secure the offtakes. That's then allowed us to secure over $1 billion of debt. So the last step remaining is to secure the equity. And the National Reconstruction Fund through the Australian government have given us $200 million of support in securing the sort of equity that we need to take the project forward.
What are the next steps then, Darryl?
Yeah, so with the equity, we want to secure about 60% of our equity, which is around $400 million, or a bit over, with cornerstone investors, at which point we will then go to the market. So we want to get to, at least 50% and ideally 60%. We've engaged with multiple parties and we're making significant progress along that pathway, and we look to finalize that around the middle of this year.
All going well, when would you expect to start production?
Yeah, so it's a 3-year construction period and a 2-year ramp up. So it is, building, quite a large mine and process plant. So it will be about 3 years for production to start, but another 2 years, so 5 years from now, before we'd see full nameplate capacity.
Darryl, the investment case for Arafura Rare Earths?
Yeah, so I, again, if you look at, you can't build electric vehicles, wind turbines, and robots without this resource. China controls nearly 90% of the market. There's not too many projects that can really come on stream in the next 5 to 10 years. And one piece of information that I think really goes to how important this supply is electric vehicle. The average price last year was $53,000. The cost of NdPr, the rare earth that enables that, is only $56. So it enables a vehicle that's worth 1,000 times more. You see the demand doubling, you see supply projects pretty short. We're one of the very few able to go into construction, and supply of this is very important to get EVs and wind turbines manufactured.
Darryl, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress with the mine. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you, Stephen. It's been a pleasure.
That's Arafura Rare Earths CEO, Darryl Cuzzubbo.